allowed to voice any concerns anyhow.
Mr. Hall, do you have Mrs. Armstrong?
Ms. Armstrong, do you have an opinion on that, ma'am?
I haven't been able to hear it terribly well. Would somebody be good enough to summarize what I can comment on?
She's still here for the meeting.
Ms. Armstrong?
Ms. Armstrong, they are requesting to make public comment, those from the public that are present.
If you want to allow them to do that regarding the business that the meeting was just adjourned, you can do that, but nothing else at this point, just the subject of the meeting for today.
That is what you're...
There was no subject. What was the subject?
This organization.
Reorganization.
But on your letter on the door, it says we can comment, right? We can...
If, that's fine.
What's on the door?
Perfect, I love that question. The attorney doesn't know what's on the door. Gotta love it.
Maybe the attorney ought to be in person.
Okay, thanks.
She has a copy of that notice.
How do you send out all these appraisals and then you tell everybody to protest? You know you screwed up. Point blank.
This is not a protest hearing, so...
I gave my voice. Don't let me in here, kick me out.
That's not...
Somebody needs to stand up. Well, you're still gonna hear it. But somebody...
Are you guys in favor of raising property values?
No comment.
No comment?
No comment?
We're taxpayers.
Well, there'll be something in the future where we can comment to you all.
So how does our taxes go up and others go down? Is what I wanna know.
You have an opportunity to come before the board.
We're before you right now.
Is that gonna be one person at a time, one family at a time, or all of us can be present for that?
How did the mayor's go from $112,000 to $39,000?
Sir, I...
You can ask her, she's right there.
We have until June 1st to submit and perform this protest on my own ranch property. And I represent several of my ranching neighbors. How, there's a thousand people at least standing outside and in here. I'm sure there are more with the same issues. Now, how are all of us, will we get extensions? How can we do all this in 2 weeks? How are we going to be able to schedule and get these protests taken care of by the board, all of that within 2 weeks? Is that enough time?
No, sir, it's not 2 weeks.
Well, it's till June 1st.
That's the time you have to make your protest.
That's what I'm saying.
But then Cindy will work with her staff and they will schedule your protest hearing at a later
date. So we just need to submit the protest by June 1st. We don't have to actually have the meeting.
And there'll be plenty of time. I've served on this board. This will be my fourth year, and we've heard lots of protests over the years. So it's scattered throughout. We even went into September.
Okay, well, I misunderstood. I thought that this had been accomplished by June 1st, and I just thought that you couldn't possibly schedule all of these protests that you're going to receive and do the hearing in 2 weeks.
We will do our best to get you scheduled in sometime in that right time.
I just need to know that I can't have time to protest.
So my question is, where does the line form to start speaking?
Speaking on...
Can we start with this gentleman here?
What would you like to speak on?
I'm pretty sure everyone wants to speak a little bit, but we're just wondering where the line forms.
Well, you know that if you give information about your individual taxing situation, you prejudice us from hearing that case. We cannot listen to you comment on your public, on your personal issue, because that comes under a protest hearing. If you're going to protest, you do it through the process, because we signed an oath before we come to the meetings that we have had no contact with taxpayers about the upcoming protest that we're about to listen to. in the future, is what I'm talking about.
Perhaps with regard to everyone here in a more broad way to look at this, is that while you have just a representative sample of the people who did take off work, or took off work whether they could afford to or not, we're all out here, and you know this is going to be multiplied by tens of thousands who are going to be filing these appeals and in these protests. But in the meantime, every one of us, speaking for anybody with a mortgage, is being noticed by their mortgage lenders and their insurance companies that their escrow is going up based upon what was sent out. I don't have an option to say I haven't reached my appeal yet, neither does anyone else. You're just going to see your mortgage go up and your homeowner's policy go up for coverage in the meantime. And those are significant numbers we're talking about based upon these valuations. People are getting hit hard. Everything's more expensive. Standing in line waiting for months to be heard by a board when the mistakes on these valuations this year are so widespread is costing Cumberland County. The lost productivity in that line out here and in your state to this city and this county is measurable. Next Friday, my firm will be closing so that I can sit down with my employees and try and figure out how we put their protests together so that I can afford to keep my business model open based upon these valuations. If I can afford to keep my employees based upon these valuations, it's important that we not, in this particular year, when these valuations are so off the chart based upon other years, we're not talking nickels and dimes here. We're talking exponential changes in valuation. Something different needs to happen this year because many of us can't afford the time or the opportunity or have the expertise to come in and argue our appraisals. But those of us who can't afford to wait our turn in line because it's taking that money out of our pockets every month already. I'm not going to speak about my individual case so that you're not prejudiced, but I can speak for everyone who has a mortgage in which you have escrow. You're already paying these taxes because they have to catch up for the last 4 months. An opportunity for everyone to be heard as a group or maybe perhaps set in a special meeting of this board so people can voice their concerns is a really great idea. You have taxpaying, hardworking members of Congreve County here who absolutely support this county. My husband is the district attorney. He knows better than anybody that we need more funds for prosecutors. We need to fix the courthouse so we can move more cases through. We need support for law enforcement. We need all of those things, and those things take money. But do it right. Do it fairly. Do it so that people have an opportunity to protest and be heard. In the meantime, they're already being taxed. It's already coming out of their pocket before their protest is heard.
I only have one statement I want to make. Who did y'all have come in and make these appraisals? It wasn't somebody local. You brought somebody from California to appraise at California values.
For this lady right here who was so courteous. Ma'am, we hear cases individually, okay? That's our job. We're independent of the appraisal district. We don't hire people, we don't do anything. We're independent, and that's why we're independent, is to give you a voice. And ours is not the final voice. We have other options beyond us.
Somebody came in.
But we're like you, we're taxpayers in this county, and we are seeing some of the same things that you brought up that are happening to us, and we are going to listen to your case one by one. One by one case. I'm telling you, last year we met numerous times. And we do that because we want everyone to have that opportunity to voice their opinion when they come in and let us know. And we're going to do our opinion. Our decisions are going to be based on what you bring, the facts, and the comparison. That's all we can tell you, man.
Mr. Holland, can I respect every member of this board who has that tough job ahead of them based upon the evaluations that came out. I think what people here would like to know is, as an independent board, board, you're catching the backlash for an appraisal valuation that came out. How do we address the individual or the entity? How do we find out where this came from so that we can address it at the source?
Ma'am, one thing that we encourage from all the people who file protests is to sit down one-on-one with one of the appraisers, specifically in most cases the one who's in charge of your appraisal, but in a lot of cases it may not be possible. So you have that opportunity to sit down. We had, I don't know how many cases we had last year that never made it to this board because they sat down with an appraiser and they worked out and figured out what was going on and why it happened and what was the reasons and things of that nature. They discussed that ahead of time. But if you're not satisfied with that procedure of going to the appraisal, you know, and no one's saying you have to. That's just an option that works in a lot of situations. You have the right to come to this ARB board and present your case. We are not tax appraisers. We don't know the book in and out. We're going to hear the cases, and we're going to prepare what we hear, okay?
So who did the appraisal, and where are they physically located?
Do what, ma'am?
Who is the tax appraiser who gave us these valuations?
Well, there's various tax appraisers in this
office. Well, as an attorney in private practice, this is a trial over our property values, and effectively, we've been told this is your verdict, unless you appeal it. This is how much you're worth, unless you appeal it. And don't we have the right then to know specifically who it is who looked and accused my property of being worth this much money?
Yes, ma'am.
That's due process.
That would be what you would do. If you want to sit down with the individual, that they can assign you to different individuals. There are all certified appraisers, and they can sit down with you, and you can ask all the questions you want about the taxes, the laws, whatever. That's their responsibility to answer those questions for you, not us.
Okay. Okay. And so for the individuals here today who want to do that, to sit down with the appraiser before filing the appeal or filing the protest, how do we get the name, how do we get an appointment to do that?
Ma'am, I would suggest that you contact the appraisal district for that information today. You can assume that, you know, there's not that many days left before June 1st, and you need to have that protest in. I would do that first. You can always call the appraisal district and cancel your protest if you get things resolved. But I would file that protest before I would do anything if I felt the way you do that.
So, thank you, sir.
Well, yes, sir.
Thank you, pardon. 3 days ago, I called to speak to a man named Scott Smetana, was my appraiser for years and years, and he worked helpfully and diligent with me on my tax managed taxes in the past. I gave a call to that phone number the day I got my appraisal estimate. I left a message, but a man of another name answered that direct line. I left a message and a phone number twice and requested a return call. To this point in time, I still have not got a call, so I have not been able to make that appointment and schedule to speak with my appraisal manager or whatever.
I understand
the
situation, but that's not a decision for this board, sir. That's an issue that you deal with the appraisal district, okay? Remember again, we're not working for the appraisal district. We're an independent group of individuals that will hear the case.
But I should talk to them first and find
out. No, sir, I said that's a suggestion. That's an offer that's worked in the past. I've sat here on this board, and it's worked in the past for some people. It does not work for everyone. I'll tell you that immediately. But it's an option that you have to work it out with them, and there's still a lot of time to do that. Yes, sir.
So if y'all hear the cases, they come to you and say, do you agree with them and lower what they think should be. Can, is there someone else that could overturn y'all's and send it back?